Hi, Derek Johnson with Tatango.com here. I'm going to show you today how to send an MMS message in mass to your subscribers. So an MMS message allows you to send more than just 160 characters of text. You get a subject line, you get up to 500 characters of text, and you get to include some type of media content. That could be a V-card, a GIF, a static image, a video. It's just a much better experience for a customer than just sending a plain 160 characters worth of text. So I've created a demo campaign here called Acme Retail. And a campaign in Tatango is where you store all of your customers' phone numbers that have opted in so that you can send them frequent mass text messages, or in this case, an MMS message. I'm going to click Manage. And when you click Manage, you're going to go to the dashboard. And the dashboard is going to give you a snapshot of how the campaign is doing at that one time. So you'll be able to see how many people are opting in, you know, who actually is opting in, who's opting out, gives you some averages. So it gives you a real good snapshot of what's going on within the campaign. So as I said, we're going to send an MMS message. So when I click Messaging, I'll then want to click New Message. But before I do that, I'm going to show you a sent text message report. So as you can see here, I sent a text message earlier today to all my subscribers, only two subscribers. And if I want to see the results of that text message, I click View Report. Now this can be for either an MMS message or an SMS message, it doesn't matter. And as you can see here, it gives you a lot of information about the message. It gives you not only a preview of the message, but it tells you when the message was sent, when it was finished sending, how many recipients there were, and a lot of statistics about how many SMS versus MMS messages were sent, how many people unsubscribed, how many people received the message successfully. If you had a link in the message, it would show you how many people clicked on that link. It shows you your coupon code usage, and then also shows you what mobile carriers your subscribers are using. In this case, it's just AT&T. And at the very bottom, it also shows you the replies to your mass text message. So this one, myself, replied to my mass text message saying, awesome deal, thank you for sending this to me. It gives a date and time of when that reply was received. At any time also, you can download the information to a CSV file. All you gotta do is click this little link. So let's go back and continue on the process of sending an MMS message to your subscribers. So here I've selected SMS, this is the default. I'm going to switch it to MMS. As you can see, there's much more stuff to put in compared to an SMS message. So first off, you get a subject line. And that subject line on most phones is going to appear in a bold font, as you can see in this preview. Then you get 500 characters for your message. And this can include text, links, even a phone number could be put into the 500 characters. So I'm going to just make up a message, save 20% off your next purchase. Use code, TXT20. And then I can go down here and I can upload an image, a video, a V card, even a GIF. You get a nice preview of what the message will look like here on the right hand side. You also get to select a fallback message, which is this fallback SMS message below. And what this is there's a small certain amount of people that cannot receive MMS messages. 1 to 2%, depending on where we are and where and when you're watching this video. But currently, it's about 1 to 2%. So for those people, that 1 to 2% that cannot receive the MMS message, what we're going to do is we're going to send them an SMS message with a link that then they can click on that link and view the MMS content on a mobile website. So I can fill this in and say, you know, save 20% off. Click here, And what we're going to do in the message processing is if they can't receive an MMS message, we're going to create a mobile website for your content, and then we're going to put in the link. So you don't have to worry about that. So I'm going to go back up here. This is a pretty standard, typical message. And if I wanted to, I could just click send MMS message and go to all my subscribers. I'm going to show you some of the more advanced features we have. So the first one is if you want to include a link, so let's say shop now, instead of putting a regular link, you can actually put a shortened URL. Now there's two reasons why you want to do this. One is a short URL is better than a long URL, especially if you're limited by the characters that you can put in a message. The second is with a short URL, you'll be able to tell how many people clicked on the link, and then you'll be able to see your click-through rate for the message, which will determine how well the message did. So as you can see here, I've included a short URL. And all I need to do is click shorten URL, and it'll shorten whatever URL I want to put in there. Now I have two shortened URLs. The next one is, let's say I want to personalize this message, and I want to put their first name into the message of all my subscribers. So each message will be personal to the subscriber. So I can go and I can select merge tag. And as you can see, there's a lot of different things I can put into a message. I'm going to find the first name. And as you can see here, it's dropped in a merge tag, which is the first name merge tag. And just to make sure that I'm doing this correctly, I can click View Dynamic Data. And what it's going to do is it's going to show me for all my subscribers what actually is going to replace that merge tag. And for this phone number, this is one of my subscribers, his name is Alex. So he's going to get a message that's personalized for him with his first name. And then if I select the right arrow and I go to my next subscriber, this is me, you can see that it's changed the first name to Derek. So Alex is going to receive a message and it's going to say, hi, Alex. And then myself, Derek, I'm going to receive a message that says, hi, Derek. The last advanced feature in terms of stuff you can put into the message is what we call a coupon code group. And essentially what a coupon code group is, it's similar to a merge tag, but it's actually pulling from a list of coupons that are unique. So the reason retailers, restaurants do this is that if you have a point of sale system that can void or cancel a unique coupon code after it's been used, then you can use those unique coupon codes and put them into a message. So Alex would get a different coupon code than myself, Derek. And then when I use one of those coupon codes, then it gets voided out of the system and I can't share that coupon code with other people and have them redeem the same promotion. So what I've done here is I've selected the coupon code group, I put it in here, and I'm actually going to put it instead of TXT20, which could work for anybody, even if it was shared on social media or, you know, just somebody told somebody else, anybody can use that one. I'm actually going to use a coupon code group. And again, if I click this refresh button here, you'll see that Derek, myself, is going to get the coupon code 12345, and Alex, he's going to get the coupon code, and again, this is just specific to his phone number, is going to get this coupon code, which is not the same as my coupon code. And when Alex uses that coupon code, then no one else can use that coupon code because it's going to be voided out in the point of sale system. So once you create a message, you're going to want to test that message to people yourself and then people in your office or people that are on your team because you want to make sure everything looks good. So all you have to do is type in a phone number. This is my phone number. And then you can type in, you know, teammates' phone numbers as well into the system. You click send test message and you can send as many test messages as you want before you send a mass text message to all your subscribers. So as you go down, you also get the option to send now or schedule your message. I'm going to click schedule. And as you see, there's a lot of different things going on here. You can either schedule a message on exactly, which is essentially on a date and a time in the future. You can also schedule a message for after an opt-in, whether that's all opt-ins, after only the initial opt-in, or after a non-initial opt-in. This is used for when people want to reward somebody for opting in to a text message campaign and they want to set it and forget it. And essentially our system, Tatango, will send a message to any new subscriber with usually a reward or promotion thanking them for opting in. As you can see here, you can also select birthday. So you could send a birthday message one day before or one day after, and you can change this if you like. I'm going to select on exactly, and I'm going to select December 15th, 1 p.m. And as you can see down here, I have selected send based on my time zone, which is the Pacific time zone. If I had a national company with multiple locations and my subscribers were in different time zones, I'd want to send based on my subscriber's time zone. So this would be sent multiple times throughout the day to your subscribers, but it would hit each subscriber at 1 p.m. no matter what time zone they're in. So this is a really great feature for companies with multiple locations in different time zones. Then at the very bottom, you see that I've selected send to entire list. This will send the message, the MMS message, to all my subscribers. If I only want to send to a certain segment of my subscribers, I would click send to a segment within the list. Now I can match subscribers by any or all the following conditions. I'm going to select all. And I can build as advanced of a segment as I want. So I could go in here and I could say, you know, state is, let's say, you know, Texas. And let's say the age is greater than 25. And let's say the gender is male. So this is a message that, you know, let's say I have 2 million subscribers, but I want to only target my customers that are male, 25 years old, or greater, and that are in Texas. Now, when I click refresh segment here, if I had anybody that actually met that very strict segment, then it would show how many subscribers I have right there. And again, you can build as complex of a segment as you want or as simple as a segment. A simple segment could be something like the wireless carrier is AT&T, or they live in a certain state, or you can build multiple segments and really narrow down your subscribers to make your messages as targeted as possible. So that's essentially it. What you need to know to send a mass MMS, again, an MMS message includes that subject line, 500 characters of text in an image or a GIF or a video or V card, some type of media content, compared to a mass text message or SMS message, which only has 160 characters of text. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching.